gentlemen, would you please welcome the teams and officials for the gold medal match of the men's team foil.
Time now for the gold medal match of the men's team foil. It is Italy against Japan. Japan's surprise win over Germany saw them progress to this final of a competition. Italy, well, they have just been absolute class throughout. A comprehensive thrashing of the United States. Close match against Great Britain. And here they are in the final. The Japanese will be on the left, the Italians on the right.
Between Japan and Italy. Introducing the team of Japan, Ryo Miyake.
So Miyake, Ota, Chida.
Yuki
are their fighting fencers. And Suguru.
Kenta Chida.
Is the substitute. There is Chida.
And Suguru Awaji.
Awaji. Suguru Awaji is the substitute.
And their opponents, the team from Italy, Andrea Baldini.
There's Andrea Baldini, the cautious, wily fencer, the great Andrea Cassara. Well, it leaped ahead.
Cassara.
Now we go back to Cassara. And then there's Evola, who we skipped to. So that's Evola. And there's the substitute, Aspromonte, who is not going to be fighting anymore after his performance against the British team, which was just not good enough, really, for an Italian team as good as these guys are.
Rios Rivera, referee.
Your assistant referees, Nick Payne and Konstantinos Liberopoulos.
So here we go, and the order is Baldini will go up against Miyake. The huddle. Well, we know all about the Italian fencers because we've effectively got world champions, world number one in the world. The Japanese
referee, please start the fight.
Ryo Miyake is a left-hander ranked 24th in the world, 21 years old, and he is going up against the wily Baldini. Now the Italians, when they faced the United States, just went off like a steam train. Might be a little more circumspect here. And the Japanese take the first point.
Hang on.
Great parry, riposte.
Hang on.
Over the back.
Ali. Contra-attack, 2-1.
Hang on. 2-0 to Japan. Not the start the Italians would want, but it's early days.
Well, I think it is the start that the neutrals would want, to be quite fair,
Ali.
Because the Japanese going into this are ranked 7th in the world, the team. And Italy obviously way out as number one. So I think anyone who's neutral, who knows fencing in the crowd, will want to see the Japanese start well.
Pare. La riposte.
First hit for Baldini and Italy. Yeah, I think that's true. The problem is the stats tell quite a strong story for the Italian team. They've met four times this season, and it's 4-0 to Italy. The closest match was the earliest one in the season, where Italy won 45-39. The others have been to 30-25 and 31, so fairly convincing. Whilst the Japanese have started well, I really don't see anyone standing on the top step of the podium other
than Ali.
High work rate from the Japanese fences, and that's a Japanese attack.
It goes through. So it's the Japanese start the attack first. It's not parried. Even though Baldini comes through and puts his light on, it was a clear Japanese point. Slow motion replays really do help people understand the sport. And if you watch it long enough, you will get your eye in, if you like, and be able to spot things at full speed that you aren't initially able to pick up on. And then you've got to have them go and give it a go yourself, I think, is the next thing. There's plenty of clubs where you can go and join. You don't have to be a kid to learn defence.
Now anyone can start fencing. It's not difficult to start.
Attacco inferno, pari, la ripostus, quale.
Puoi entrare quando viene lui, lavora bene come si muove lui.
All you need is a pair of tracksuit bottoms and a couple of t-shirts,
Ali.
A pair of socks and some trainers, and off you go.
Al, attack.
Attempted parallel post from Baldini.
Baldini
fails.
La massima plec.
Rio Miyake. Fantastically well for the Japanese team.
Attack the Goji Novala. Angar, pre.
So Miyake's attack was off target, and it's a bit of blade straightening.
Angar, pre. Ali. Al, attack, Nobala. Anga. Pre. Ali. Al. Please. Hangar, pre. Ali. Al, and final, attack pare, contra pare, no balab. Hangar. Pre. Ali. Al, attack. Tuf. Juan. Baldini, please. You must dialogue. Angar. Angar, pre. Ali. Al. Attack, pare. Repose, no balab. Angar. Angar, pre.
So,
Ali.
4-3. 32 seconds left on the clock. Still time for Baldini to get ahead, to get to five first. Well, no, there isn't. And Baldini's complaining about movement of the head, and we're going to a video replay.
I can't see anything wrong. We've got big screen replays here. in the venue. There's a good play for you. Nothing there that prevented Baldini from trying to score, so that's it.
And
that's
so, after the first out of nine bouts, Japan leading Italy 5-3. Up next on Peace for Italy, Giorgio Avila versus from Japan, Yuki Ota.
Well, Italy have got the early lead. Japan have got the early lead 5-3. But honestly, since it's the last day of fencing here in XL, I will eat my microphone if Italy don't come through and win this.
Come on, Japan.
Hangar. Pre. Ali.
No, Italy are clear favourites to win this.
Attack.
Two
no
early to call. Let's look at it after three of the nine bouts.
Hang on.
Relay format.
Pre. Ali.
First fences go up to five or a maximum of 3 minutes, and the next two adopt that score. They go up
to ten. Attack. Pare. Riposte touche. One.
Otto has scored the first point in the second leg.
Hang on.
It's a maximum of 45 Pre. Hits, three against three.
Ali.
Predefined before the start of
attack.
The match.
Anger. Pre. Ali.
If you don't reach the target score, so for example in this match, if we don't get one team to 10 hits, the next team go on to the third match, you take the three and multiply it by five to give you the target score, and that's still the target score. So the target score in the next match is 15.
Hang on. Pre. Ali.
So Yuki Ota, 1-0 up against
Al. And final attack Pare. La riposte Novala. Hang on. Hang on. Ali. Al, attack Novala. Hang on. Pre. Ali. Al, attack Novala.
From Avola.
Hang on.
Off target. And even though Otto scored on the
Ali.
Target, there was he didn't have the right of way.
Ah, attack by the other one.
Right. So Avola scores a hit for Italy.
Hang on. Pre. Ali. Ah, attack on the voice. Two. One.
And Otto gets one back
Pre.
For Japan,
Ali.
7-4. If Otto can get to 10.
Al, attack Pare, la riposte no, remise no valable. Hang on. Pre. Ali. Al, attack Novala. Hang on. Pre. Ali. Al, attack Premier No. I stop.
No
attack the Bosch at 1-2.
For Avola to start with. And that gives Otter the right of way. And I can't see the referee changing his mind, but he's going to go and look at the review and gets a nod from his colleague.
Touch one.
Yeah, and he sticks with
Anger.
His decision.
Pre, allez. Attack, pare. La riposte touche. One.
That one goes to Evola.
Anger. Pre, allez.
Might have just fired him up a bit. Italians starting uncharacteristically slowly.
Ah, l'attaque confère, non balab. Anger.
Idea, idea.
Prêt? Allez. Préparation, attaque par de droit, à gauche touche, point. Einger. Pre. Allez.
So three apiece is the score in this bout between Otter and Evola. Japan with a 2-point advantage. The target is 10. The clock is ticking down. 40 seconds left. Don't reach the target,
no,
then the score
no,
is adopted by the Anger. Next round of fences. Next bout of fences, the third
Allez.
Bout. And the target will move up to 15.
Attack, pare. La riposte no, remise no balla.
Evola. But he can only hit off target.
Pre. Allez.
One to the Japanese, and it brings them one away from a target score of 10.
Anger. Pre. Ali. Al attack on Ferno Vola.
Target there. Vola.
Pensa lo pari quando viene 13. Se viene lui ci lavori lì.
Einger, pre, alle. Attack offer, no, pare.
Attack is parry.
La riposte touche, point.
Good for Evola.
Einger.
And Evola's doing well. He's keeping in touch for a piece.
Einger,
six
pre.
Seconds left on the
Allez.
Clock. Are they going to attack? No, they're not. Well, they called it for.
So, ladies and gentlemen,
the
there
Italians,
we are at the second interval.
I have to say,
with Yuki Ota of
like
Japan,
a bullet train
holding on
from
to the
Tokyo
two-hit advantage
to Kobe,
for Japan
this
over
Japanese
Italy.
Team are speeding
9-7
through the Italians
as we go into the third leg with Kenta Chida of Japan taking
certainly
on Andrea
Japanese
Cassara
bullet
of Italy.
But I think, with Cassara coming on, things may turn around for the Italians. Cassara is their ace card. He can and he has the ability to score points very, very quickly.
Onga.
He works someone out.
Okay.
There's very little he can do.
Alt, attack, non block, on guard.
Straight up the blocks.
Prêt, allez.
Off, oh, not quite off the back line.
Parade, riposte, non block. Onga.
Very, very close to the back line.
Pep. Ale. Attack. Nongora. Onga. Pep. Ale.
That time, one light on.
Push. Kwan.
It's almost like the power in the hit kind of stops. Japanese fencer from
Onga.
Fred. His momentum Ale. Coming forward. It's down.
Ai, Baradri Poste Nombra. Onga. Fred. Ale. Ai, Tratak no.
A big man who can kind of move his body around. Look at the agility here. He hits, ducks, closes everything down. Keeping his head up, keeps it all legal.
Onga.
Now we hear the Italian fans.
Pet, Ale.
Well, this is the first time they've gone back
Onga.
Level on scores,
Pet.
I think, since
Ale.
The very first point. Watching a grown man against his boys.
Yeah, he's huge.
And yet he can move so fast.
No. Onga. Ale.
And as Cassara steps in, it looks like Tudor scores.
Bravo.
Let's see. Cassara won't be happy with this. And then he goes.
Paraz contra Paraz de Jose Tuch.
I mean, that's
Onga.
Tudor's hit, isn't it? How's that not
Onga.
Tudor's hit?
Onga.
How's that not Tudor's hit?
Onga.
That was quite phenomenal.
Tudor. Gato.
Quite phenomenal.
Onga.
Cassara's arm is right back. Pet. His arm is he's looking Ale. To the blade. Tudor hits him.
Ale.
And then
no.
starts his attack.
Contra attack Tuch. Juan. Onga.
So Onga. 10 apiece.
Pet. Ale.
You can only go on what the referee says.
Oh, I mean, yeah. The video replays running around the entire stadium here clearly shows that that hit was
Onga.
Tudor's. Clearly.
Pet. Ale. Ai. Paradri Poste Nombra. Onga. Pet. Ale.
So we're on to the third bout. So the target is 15.
Ai. Tratan. Push.
Stops him down. Yes, he has done.
Onga. Onga. Pet. Ale. Ai. Attack Tuch. Juan.
That's correct. Tudor runs in and tries to look for a cheeky parallel cast in the first quarters. But Sorrel is ready for that one. But there you go. He tries to look for it. The blade's not there.
Onga. Pet. Ale. Alright, attack, prepare. Tuch, Juan.
Yeah,
Onga. Pre. Are. Ai. Tumis Nombara. Onga.
So off target.
Dai, dai, dai. Ancora tu, ancora tu.
Showing.
Pre. Are. Ai.
Oh, he's come through.
Goose.
12 apiece.
Onga. Pre. Are.
We're working with the Japanese.
Paradri
Pose
Nombara.
Italy have all the
Onga.
Expectations and
Pre.
Pressure
Are.
Of being such clear favourites. And yet, can just turn some people up.
Attack no.
Counter attack to
Huang. Onga. Pre.
But Cassara's made up all the deficits, 6-3, and now Italy are in
Are.
The lead.
Ai! No, Nombara. Onga.
Called halt.
Pre. Ai! Ai! Attack Nombara. Onga. Pre. Ai! Ai! Paradri Pose Touche, Juan.
So two, they're
Onga.
Keeping Japanese powder dry and keeping the Italian team honest.
Pre.
13 apiece.
Ai.
Oh, the phenomenal Touche. Agility Juan. Of Andrea Cassara, such a big man,
Onga.
Makes
Onga.
A parallel pass that doesn't
Onga.
Register, and somehow in close quarters, the big man is able to fashion a hit at the same time as not
Onga.
Getting hit. Great.
Pre. Are. Attack. Nombara. Onga. Pre. Are. Ai. Nombara. Onga. Pre. Are. Ai. Attack.
Nice, there we go.
Push.
And that is it. Cassara has made up all the deficit.
8 hits to 4.
Yeah, 8 hits to 4 in that bout.
15-13 lead as we move into the fourth leg.
15-13 now. The tide, I think,
will come on for Japan,
has turned
Giorgio Avola
in the Italians'
Italy.
Favour. Well, we'll see how Avola gets on now against Ryo Miyake of Japan.
Normal order is restored, and it looks like we are going to see a Japanese substitution, I believe. They're filling in some paperwork. We'll keep an eye on that one.
Yeah, their substitute is
Onga.
Pre. Ale.
Why do you come on, I believe, for Chida, the fencing has just come off, but we'll keep an eye on that. We need to wait till the next fight.
Atas, Touche, Juan.
Avola standing still and getting pulled.
Onga. Pre. Ale.
Steps in. Miyake looks for the blade. Avola just steps into distance. Very nice.
Onga. Pre. Ale. Art. Attack. Nombara. Onga. Pre. Ale.
Well, I've got to say, it's a closer match than we were expecting. come out of the first third of this contest and only be 2 points
Honga.
Still in it, the Japanese, very much still in it.
Yeah, very much still in it. They are just a couple of hits adrift. This target light comes up. Just clip the foil back in, probably. Oh no, he's exchanging it straight away. A no-risk strategy adopted by Giorgio Avola of Italy. He asks for a replacement foil. And that's an appropriate moment to give a big cheer to the volunteers who've been assisting here at the fencing hall.
Honga.
Done a fantastic job.
Prep. Ale. Aye. That's up.
One light.
Yeah, one light on. Can go only one way. 17-14.
Honga. Prep. Ale. Ale. Fina.
First quarters. Miyaki wins the battle.
You're not control lock.
Honga.
Tries to some hit from what we call prune hand up high above the head. Sword pointed down towards the target.
He's holding his own.
Right, attack, Nombara. Honga. Honga, Pret, Ale.
Yeah, Avola and Baldini are very similar in their approach, aren't they?
Ai, Nombra.
They don't go rushing in, they don't bully their opponent.
And you see you have another weapon change, a big bend in the blade, that straighten it out. Often if a foil bends
Honga.
That close to the guard,
Pret.
It creates a big Ale. Weakness in the weapon and that bend will keep appearing and eventually just as I throw it out.
Hi, Prata. Push. One.
Lucky. Yeah, that's good. The staying in touch.
Honga. Honga. Pet. Ale. Ale, Rata, Nomura. Honga.
Pet. Allez.
Well, the target score for this bout is 20, and
final number.
Avola is just Onga. Sneaking towards it now.
Onga. Onga. Pet. Ale.
Standing for any time wasting. From Giorgio Avola, tells him to get on guard.
Ah, yeah. Attack no. Contra-attack touch, one. Onga.
Well, Miyake's done very, very well. And the Japanese are still in it. The pace of this match has slowed right down. 30 seconds on the clock.
Ai! Onga.
Of course, if Evola scores, then that will be it. If Miyake scores, well, we can keep going, because it's not who gets up to five, it's who reaches the target score for the team that counts.
Onga. Fred. Allez.
Time comes.
Salut.
To an end of this bout.
So there we are at the end of the fourth leg. Time ran out.
And still two
the
points
Italian
in it.
Still holding a two-hit lead over Japan. 19-17.
Yeah,
the two fences to come on. Kenta Chida from Japan against Andrea Baldini of Italy. This leg can go up to 25.
So Avola, 4-all against Otta in the second bout, and 4-all against Miyake. It's Cassara that's really the danger man, I think, for the Italian teams. Baldini on now. I expect this bout will go maybe even to the full 3 minutes again. It's It's just ticking along, and the Japanese are just hanging in there.
Ali. Contra attack, no ball. Aengar. Pre. Ali.
Very good body language from the Italian box, I have to say.
Aengar.
Cassara or Avola.
Aengar, pre.
Had their head in the towel and tucked Ali. Between their legs.
Al. Aengar. Pre. Ali. Al, attack. Tush.
It's bad to lose it.
Video. Aengar, pre. Pre. Ali. Al, attack, confer. Attack, confer, no balab. Video.
Well, Aldi is called for a video replay.
Outside. Nobala. Aengar. Aengar. Pre. Ali. Al. Attack pare. La riposte no. Remise. Attack touche. Juan. Aengar.
Fai venire lui. Fai muovere lui.
Aengar. Pre. Aengar. Pre. Ali.
So, 2 minutes left on the clock of
attack,
this bout.
No. Contra attack, touche. Juan.
Gets the hit. Baldini.
Masterpiece. Aengar.
Well, once the Italians start questioning things and...
Baldini. Aengar.
And just basically moaning. It's a sign that
Aengar.
They are slightly rattled.
Pre. Ali. Al, attack, no bala. Aengar. Pre. Ali. Attack, no bala.
So no
Aengar.
Point for the Italian. It's the Japanese attack, the off-target one that had the
Aengar.
Right of way.
Pre. Ali.
Oh, that's a bit more like it. That's going to get the crowd going, I think.
Baldini. Baldini.
It's been very, very tactical.
Lamas. Touche. Carton John.
And what was the yellow card there for Baldini?
I was watching Tudor re-enter the piece, so I'm not sure what
Aengar.
He's given the card for.
Pre. Aengar. Pre. Ali. Attack, premier pare, la riposte no. Contra pare, riposte touche. Juan.
So counter post has been given. And Tudor calls for a video review. Apparently, there's the riposte, it doesn't hit. Wow. Let's say that Tudor has a bit of an argument here, but what does the referee say? Nope, he doesn't.
Aengar. La main, s'il vous plaît. Aengar.
Senza tutto quello spazio.
Aengar, pre. Ali.
Beauty. Sabre closes the distance and scores with a counteraction.
Anga. Pre. Ali. Al. And final attack. Push. One.
Well, that one was Baldini's. Four apiece.
Anga. Anga.
A running attack and timed it right to get the flick over on the shoulder.
Ad, preparation attack de voice novalab. Anga. Anga. Pre. Ali. Ad, attack novalab. Anga. Pre. Ali. Al, and final attack for it. La riposte no remise attack to.
Finally, the Italians look like they're making some progress. Yet one point away from taking it to the target score of 25. 25-21 with their big hitter Cassara coming on next.
Anga.
Japanese.
Pre.
Do something here. Need this next point. And they've got it.
One.
Oh, right on target.
Anga.
Right on cue.
Anga. Anga. Pre. Ali. Al attack Novalab. Anga. Pre. Ali. Attack the boys in Novalab. Anga.
Pazienza, che venga lui. Siamo avanti.
Pre.
Ali. Can get the next one.
Ad.
Effectively narrow the gap.
Anga. Pre.
Chile can score Ali. More than five, obviously. If something Baldini.
Attack confer. Tous les deux. L'attaque confer. L'attaque de droite. À gauche touche. One.
And it is. So Italy 25.
Tous les deux.
Japan 22. One. And that rather long and tactical bout is over, with Baldini going up 6-5 over Chida.
Well, there's a big one coming up now. Yuki
so
Otto comes on for Japan, and he goes up against Andrea Cassara.
Italy leading Japan 25-22.
Now, Yuki Otto
up next,
is
Andrea Cassara. For Italy,
the Japanese
and Yuki Otto
anchor man
for Japan.
A man that they trust with the last bout.
Anga.
Cassara is the big hitter Pre. For Italy.
Ali. Ah, la tape par la droite, gauche touche, one.
And there you go.
Number one for Italy.
He scores quickly, doesn't he?
Yeah, he wants to get on with this.
Anga. Pre.
This is his chance to
Ali.
Redeem himself, Andrea Cassara, from his standards.
Attack,
was a
Novalab.
Individual competition.
Attention, s'il vous plaît.
Well, by his standards, if he doesn't win, it's
Anga.
A poor individual.
Pre. Ali. Ah, l'attack non paré. La riposte touche point.
Yuki Otto.
Yuki, Yuki. Oh, it's good to come here.
Anga. Pre. Ali. Alt, alt, alt. Io sai di pista.
sure what the referee's
saying. Hang on. Pre, Ali. Al, attack, no, parry. La riposte, no valor.
No riposte from Cassara. He parried the blade.
Hang on.
Sure, but
Pre.
He wasn't able to Ali. Land with the riposte as Otto motored past him.
Al, attack, confirm.
Two beats, push, flick one. The chest. Very tactical battle, this one.
Hang on. Pre.
Packed Ali. Out the stadium again.
Al, attack, no
ball. All 8,000 seats are taken, certainly on the other side.
Hang on. Pre. Ali.
Packed out.
Attack, Pare.
La riposte is given.
One.
Yeah, a Cassara can defend as well as you can attack.
Pre. Ali. Al.
Referee calls halt, he lost the phrasing.
Hang on. Pre. Ali.
Yeah, they were a bit too fast, weren't they?
Ah, contra-attack, two.
Ah,
one.
Cassara's got two of his arm back. Luki Otto jumps in and sticks his arm in there. 5, 27.
Hang on. Pre. Ali. Al. Attack.
Again.
No.
Contra-attack. Action
one.
Replay
Hang
of
on.
The previous point.
A contortion there.
Pre. Pre. Ali.
Cassara is getting
one.
Caught here. And
Hang
the
on.
Scores are tied at 27 apiece. Luki Otto's 5-2 up against Cassara.
Al, attack, pare. La riposte no valor. Hang on. Pre. Ali. Attack de gauche. Pare. La riposte touche. One.
Well, that one goes to Cassara. This is the 6th of 9 bouts. So the target score
Pre.
Is 30.
Ali.
This is effectively the last bout of the middle third.
Ah, l'attaque on fait de gauche. La droite touche.
Yuki one. Otto is playing an absolute blinder.
Hang on. Pre.
6-3 is up now against Cassara. 28
Ali.
Apiece.
Still attack.
Referee's going to get that for a time that Otto's called for a replay.
He's
given the line. Andrea Cassara is not happy about that. But instead of it being Italy 1 point better off, it's now Japan 1 point better off.
I know, this could be a start thinking about a major, major upset.
Al, attack, no ball up.
Did say I would eat my microphone.
Hang on.
It's not really particularly tasty.
I was just going to say we might have to wait a little bit longer for that, but I'll go and get
one
that.
Al, attack. Tush.
Maybe some mustard. Tomato ketchup will do the trick, but it's now all tied at 29 apiece.
Hang on. Pre.
So
Ali.
The next point will take us through to.
Al, attack.
Next bout, and it's gone to Cassara. So, we are on to the last third of this competition. It's Chida against Avola.
And after the sixth bout, their very close match between Yuki Ota and Andres Casari. It's
one
just edging out
seven,
in front.
Five.
30 points to 29. Up next for Italy, Giorgio
Yuki Ota, and it
and
brings
Japan,
the Japanese
Kenta Chida
right back into this contest. Kenta Chida will face Giorgio Avola. Giorgio Avola, substitute, came in for Valerio Aspromonte after Aspromonte performed not up to standard by the Italians against the British team. The British team took the Italians to 45-40.
Onga.
Yeah, they just stepped away from you in the last.
Pet. Ale.
Despite the valiant effort from.
Ah, contra-attack, no. Contra-attack, touch. One. Onga. Onga. Pet. Ale. Ah, contra-attack, Nomura. Onga.
Chida's attack.
Pet. Ale.
Target.
Ah, paradri post. Touch. One. Onga. Pet. Ale.
He's called halt. He's just looking at the replay, the referee.
Same time. L'attack please per touch. One. Onga.
And he's given it to Avola.
Pet. Ale. Alright, l'attack, no more. Onga. Pet. Ale. Tak primi e nombra.
Yeah, that one goes Onga. To the target. There was a questionable one given against
Pet.
Chida and against Casara. But that one
Ale.
Was given off target.
L'attack please pair. Touch. Twang. Mask.
Yeah.
Mask.
Quite right. Put your mask on.
Onga. Video.
If he was awarded that to Chida, it was his attack all the way, and you could tell it was a counter-attack because Avola looks to block it afterwards. Right. He's gesticulating the referee.
Touch. Onga. Mask.
There we go. Quick chat with the video. Ref,
Pet?
A very quick chat Ale. With the video ref. I think the video ref didn't even allow the referee to get anywhere near
him. He just said, off you go.
Yeah, that's, you were right.
Alright,
Paradri Poste Touch. That is a very, very good parallel request.
Bravo, bravo. Parallel bad in
form. Yeah.
Honga. Finishing it and then flicking down.
Pet.
Nose height down into the chest.
Alright, attack the number up. Onga. Pet. Ale. Attack. Push.
Attempted counter, failed.
Oh,
Honga. Pet. Ale.
So Chida scores with attack. Renovora tries to step in on the counter.
Para Adri Pose Nongora.
Chida.
Honga. Pet. Ale. Attack number.
Target. From the left, from Chida.
Honga. Pet. Ale. Aye.
He's off the piste.
Chida. Chida. Chida.
Honga. Pet. Ale. Aye.
For me, the beat comes from Vola. Two lights come up. For all intents and purposes, it looks like they're both attacking at the same time. But for me, it looks like Vola does the beat. Referee goes to consult with the video. So look at this.
Yeah, both beat it together.
Yeah, it looked like it was an outside beat, a six beat from Chida. Just for me, the feeling of a stronger beat came from Giorgio Vola.
And the decision
attack
is
push one
to Vola.
Onga.
And of course.
Prep. Ale.
So the target is 35. And these 2 points, 2 points separating them, could be crucial. There's only one point now, though.
Yeah, Vola tries to parry Tudor's attack. I think he does actually parry it, but he can't land the riposte. And Chida hits with a continuation.
Onga.
One more for Chida, and this Japanese sexual disorders are going to be crazy.
Yeah.
Contra-attack number. Honga.
Troppo vicino per star fermo.
Ale.
Forza.
Attack number. Honga. Honga.
So 48 seconds left on the clock.
Ale.
Italy can get to 35. The bout will be over because that is a
attack
score.
Number. Honga. Pet. Ale. Attack.
Oh yes. That is it. Giorgio Vola has moved them on. 35-33. A slender advantage.
End of the seventh leg.
Going into the penultimate
bout. 35-33 ahead of Japan. Coming on to the piste.
Andre Cassara takes to the piste.
Against Suguru Awaji, the reserve for the Japanese team.
Now they've played the reserve and Awaji is on, and this is the biggest moment of his fencing career.
Onga.
Having to take on
Ale.
The world champion, the world number one.
Attack number.
And Cassara will go after him.
Onga. Distance.
Onga. Pet. Ari. Ari. One.
Now. Hasara, Mas. I've brought the Wadji on.
Hasara, Mas.
For this fight.
Hasara. Onga.
But the Wadji would have been studying Gasara.
It is interesting though, have they brought him on to ensure that he gets a medal, whichever colour it is?
Ari.
Or have they brought him on because there is an injury?
Or do they think that the Wadji can do something special against Gasara? I don't think it's in their mentality to just bring someone on just so they can get a medal. Not when they're this close. This must be a tactical substitution. And they must have a game plan.
Ari. Ari. Onga. Pret. Ari. Ari. Paradripo se nombra. Onga, distance. Pret, Ari. Attack number, premium. Onga. Pret, Ari. Ari, apre Ari. Apre Ari, ampie, Onga. Onga.
Suguru, Amata wa Genki, Ashi Pai.
Pret. Ari. Ari, to attack the toes. One.
And.
Ilio!
Ilio! Hold on to your hats. Because Japan.
Onga.
Are tied up now.
Pret. Onga. Pret. Ari. Art. Paradripo se nombra.
So here we go, 35 apiece. The target score is 40.
Onga. Pet. Ale.
Whoa. What have we got going on here?
Pazienza, gira la palla!
Onga. Pet, Ari. Ari, to attack no. Contra attack push, one.
Mas.
The Japanese coach. There's a big smile on his face.
Ali.
He knows the Wadji is going to us.
Okay. Oh, but there goes Gasara.
Awaji, Awaji, Mas.
That's what Gasara does so well.
Gaton.
And Awaji's been given a yellow card.
Onga. Pet. Ali.
Nice. Kassar's, I don't know what he's complaining about. Dropping of the head.
There's nothing doing there. Already hit.
Thank you.
these two have met a couple of times in this Olympic cycle, and can't see this being a tactical substitution because Cassara's won all of them.
Right.
Rather peculiar, I don't know.
Sanjay.
He's changed it, and he's going to the car. A duck here. A head.
Olga.
Raju. And that edges Cassara just one step closer. The guys shake hands in the middle.
Red. Ale.
That is a Raju's. He needs a couple more. He needs to get a couple more to give Yuki Ota a fighting chance against Andrea Baldini.
Honga. Pit. Ari. Ai. Honga. Pit. Ari. Ai.
He doesn't get them.
Are, push, one. Cassara, Cassara.
And that's it for the penultimate bout, and Cassara has done pretty well there.
So,
5-4.
Italy prevail in that match. Now, going into the last leg with a 3-2
Ota against Andrea Baldini.
Yuki Ota of Japan. And Andrea Baldini of Italy.
Anger. Pre. Ali.
Japanese need to score fast, and they don't. And Yuki Ota is calling for the video replay, and they both look to our left because that's where the screen is. In fact, there are screens all over the hall. So, who started the attack first? Was it parried? Was there a delay in the attack? No. Attack good all the way by doing.
Anger, pre, Ali. Al. Anger. Pre, Ali. La riposte pare, contra riposte one.
That time,
check it.
A couple of exchanges, and it is given to Yuki Ota.
Touche. Hangar. Hangar.
E sono la tua.
Hey, the video, in the video. Sua, via. Sua, via.
Well, Baldini's saying it hit him off target, and it's still registered.
Ladies and gentlemen, could we ask you to have the best of order, please, to allow the referees to make the correct decisions, and also for respect to the athletes. Thank you.
Video grande.
Anga.
Sì, touche, ma change.
Cambio.
Lo sai di più.
Vieni qua.
Lo sai di
più.
Baldini.
Qui. Qua, devi andare qua dietro.
Vieni.
Qua dietro.
It's going to change his jacket. A strange time to do that.
Well, he thinks that he's sweating so much.
Here, if the fencer's white kit gets very damp from sweat, it can record a valid hit. Now, it is the fencer's responsibility to look after his own kit, and that includes if the kit gets too wet. So the hit is valid for Yukiota, but obviously the Italian fencer will want to change the kit. So it'll just take a few moments for him to prepare into the clean kit.
So 41 plays 38. Baldini against Otter. With a 3-point lead. You would say that Baldini ought to be able to see this out, but the Japanese Otter is going to go after him.
Yes, yes, yes.
Why? Do I send the commission?
No.
Yeah, with 4 points left for Baldini to close out the last of the fencing events. I have to say that Otter has an awful lot of work to do. Now, Otter's an irrepressible character off and on the piste. And he's going to do it his utmost.
Anger.
Baldini is wily and get back on the way. 2:32 on the
carrier cost.
Straight away, Baldini edges them.
Anger.
To the final gold medal of the fencing event at 2012.
So 45 the target. Baldini just needs 3 more to take Italy across the finish line.
Al, attacco inferno balla. Angar. Angar, pre. Ali. Attack, no balla.
It's the attack. Angar. Target from Baldini that time.
Pre. Ali.
Beauty.
Push.
What a leap halfway through that attack.
Anger.
Hits Otto just
Anger.
On the shoulder.
Ali.
Conversation between the blades, a number of beats back and forth. And finally, it's Otter that wins that conversation.
Anger. Pre. Ali. Al. Attack.
Tush. Italy. 44-39. Stefano Cerioni knows that his team are 1 point away from gold.
Baldini will take his time. It's not Cassara, he won't rush on.
And he's done it! He has done it, Italian! Italy have won! The team foil!
Okay.
gold medal. Baldini stands. He's going to have to salute. Cassara's a little bit too early to come onto the piece. He salutes his opponent. And here come the team. Andre Cassara, a bowler, and Aspromonte. Plus the coaches all getting involved. It's big group hugs all around. And Italy can add the men's team foil gold medal to the women's team foil gold medal as well. And the Japanese, well, they put up a brave fight. 39 points against the Italians was a very respectable score. And halfway through the contest, they were very much still in the game. But the Italian class just came through in the end. Cassara, the big hitter. Baldini, the wily character. And Evola, just absolute pure class. And Italy thoroughly deserved their gold medal. Well, the Japanese did put up a very good fight.
Yeah, they tested the Italians, who were also tested earlier on today by a brave host nation team, Great Britain. The Italians thank their adoring fans, and Cassara can't quite believe it. He's world number one, world champion, Olympic champion. He is a piece of fencing class in a giant Italian body. He is just something very, very special. And Japanese are around the coloured piece, acknowledging their fans as well. They've had a lot of support here. Lots of Japanese flags waving all round this arena. But you have to say, the Italians came here to win. Your microphone is safe.
Yes, exactly. This is the last day of fencing here in XL. And although I won't have to use it again, I wasn't actually looking forward to eating my microphone. The Italians gave us a little bit of a worry halfway through. The Japanese very close, but it was Italy all the way in the end. And we will prepare the centerpiece for the medal ceremony, which will take place in just a few moments' time.